more than you'll say, 'cause all my feelings are more than I can let by or not. It's more than you've got, just follow the day.
Everyone remembers the heady days of 1992. How could we ever forget? We in the Donegal G.A.A community has now recognised that our infrastructure needs to be upgraded if we are once again to reach those lofty heights. However, we in Donegal are not known for shirking a challenge, and this one too will be met head on and overcome.
You know, the Centre of Excellence is something that's been in the pipeline for a long time, and I suppose to finally see it come to fruition would be, you know, a brilliant achievement for the county, and obviously on an individual basis for the team it would be fantastic for us to have that resource available to us. We're really looking forward to that day, you know, that we can have our own centre and we can sort of get all our training and planning done in the one area, and I think it'll have a huge impact on the underage teams in the county as well, and hopefully now in the coming weeks and months everybody can get behind the project and the money can be raised and there's a good appetite for to make the project happen out there, and you know, the benefits are just fantastic for the team, and hopefully we can get it up and running as soon as possible.
The current position, I suppose, where we are at the moment as a county, I suppose, senior team, and I'm sure that's the same with the hurlers and also the underage teams too, is that we're you know, you've no home or nothing really set in stone as regards a training base, you know, and you know that has repercussions as regards trying to plan, you know, and I suppose you're kind of really fortunate, you're kind of, I suppose, backing on the goodwill of clubs around the county, you know, for them to, you know, give us a lend of the training facilities for the night, you know. So I suppose as a young fella too, going up through the ranks as at underage, you know, it was the exact same thing. You had no real set training base, and I suppose now with this new training base, hopefully and the goodwill of everybody around the county, if they you know, really get on behind it, it's going to have a massive impact as us as for players. You know, where we know where we're going to be training, and we're going to have a top class facility that'll really match anything around Ireland, and it's going to be massive for our preparations going into the heat of battle and championship.
Well, it'll be very important for us as a coach because we run out a number of coaching courses, award ones and award twos, and we need venues for those from a coach education point of view. And from a hurling point of view, we have development squads under 13s, under 14, 15, 16 and 17, and we're playing at A grade now in Ulster, and we need good facilities in order for the hurling to develop. In terms of football, we have development squads at under 14, 15, 16, 17 and 8 and minor level, and we need venues to play matches, particularly at under 14 where we have a number of divisional teams, and we need venues for training and preparation of all these teams, and the facilities is essentially, particularly for our youth in the county for the future.
We've made a lot of progress on the Centre of Excellence here in Convey since start. Present time, all of the major earthworks have been done, all of the major drainage has been done. Right-hand turning lane on the main road, etc. Two pitches where we're now standing were sown out last August, and as you can see now, there's a good crop of grass on them. These pitches will be available for play in August of this year. Our next priority will be to fence the perimeter of the site to protect the pitches from any outside influences. And the other priority will be to provide floodlighting so that the pitches will be usable next winter. At the moment, the bases for the floodlighting are in situ, so it's a matter now of getting the floodlighting completed. Next priority after that would be to provide dressing rooms, changing rooms for the players, in order that we can use the facility here. Longer term then, we will be developing two other pitches, pitches 3 and 4, which are along the main road. There's also provision as well for a 3G pitch at some stage in the future when funding becomes available. Very important now that everybody in Donegal and outside Donegal who has an interest in Donegal football get behind the Centre of Excellence and provide funding to it. You know, without the funding we can't move forward. A lot of money has been spent on so far, but any money that will be spent in the future, you'll be able to see progress, you'll be able to see structures going up and taking place.
If we can put in place the proper, up-to-date training facilities, we'll get back into the big time. The new facility to be built in Convoy will give us state-of-the-art facilities in line with other counties. A home for our county teams, not just in football, but also for our hurlers, camogie players and lady footballers. This new facility will allow us to provide basic training for our underage talent and ensure that players, coaches and administrators are provided with every opportunity to succeed. We now ask you to support us in Club Tyrconnell. The road ahead will no doubt be challenging, but with your help and safe in the knowledge that Donegal Gaels throughout the world are behind this project, we will be successful.